need a different dish.
Oof. Yeah, it's hot.
Ooh, child. Greetings. Fuck me and welcome. Thank you for stopping by here on TikTok Live at The Real Bloom From Within Love. I go by Bloomy. Hope y'all doing well. Wherever you're on the globe, if you are logging in live on TikTok, it is Saturday, June the 4th, 2022. Otherwise, when you all are logging on later on the YouTube, just welcome and thank you for joining. It is a general collective tarot reading, oracle reading. Hold on, let me fix this. I'm sorry. Gee whiz, man. Could y'all see me? Regarding someone's Dharma. So this reading is going to be about someone's Dharma. Dharma meaning what? Good karma. For whatever it is that you have graduated through. So I am pleased to be doing a reading that's more about the lighter side of things after going through the tower to get to the Phoenix rising. So this is for whoever, okay? It could be you, it could be someone on your mind, but that's why I put someone's Dharma, okay? I could have put your Dharma, but I don't know that. So this is actually someone's Dharma, whoever is in this energy that's gonna come out the reading, okay? So just simply take what resonates. Somebody says, hey, I got a different angle here. So I'm trying to see if it's going to work because I feel like I'm far away. So just hold on one second, guys. Feel like I'm far away. Feel like I have to yell. And I don't want to do that. So bear with me here. I was trying to just, you know, switch it up a little bit. That's all. Switching her up a little bit. Got the sage burning here in the background. Let's see how this is going to work. Can you all see me? There I am. I need to fix my nails. That's the last thing I'm going to do. Getting ready. I haven't got to I did everything else, but I haven't got to the hands yet, the nails. So I'll have to do all that later. But thank you for joining, y'all. I'm going to try to do this so y'all can see old Bloomy bloom, okay? Somebody's, because this is a big table. If you guys can see, I'm like, that's why it seems so far. I'm like, this is a wide-ass table. But it serves. I'm grateful. I'm not complaining. All right. Somebody's Dharma. Let's get the energy. I had a good Reiki session earlier. I did a Akashic Record reset, clearing, atonement, angel healing numbers. It was, man, it was the shiznit, okay? I did one on behalf of me and my son, and it was like, it was dope. That's all I'm gonna say. I feel good. Whole energy. The whole energy in the whole house. I was like, see, that's what I'm talking about. Where like I felt it. I sensed my son shift, his whole little energy get down changed. I was like, yeah, getting in them Akashic records. You know what I'm saying? So my galactic fam came through. It was just good. It was really good. Ancestors came through. All of that. So anyway. I may have to change this angle because I wanted y'all to be able to see cool shit, but you can't see my hands. Yay. Okay. Let's get the overall energy. So in other words, I'm already prepared. Had a good energy session. Boy, it was one of them thorough ones. It wasn't the quickie kind. It was thorough. And needed lighting on behalf of whoever that someone is, someone's Dharma for enduring, for passing these tests, going through the towers into their phoenix rising. So somebody is manifesting dharma. In other words, their good karma. I am honored. I am pleased. I am thankful. I'm grateful now to be able to do this kind of reading, my team. Okay. Ding dong. I'm grateful. I'm so grateful. High vibrational benevolent energies for a change, a little bit of break, concentrating on the dharma of these individuals now, okay? So let's get the heart, intuitive guidance, and messages from Spiritual AF, the root and heart as to why they're receiving the dharma. It's something. There's a heart, there's a root. They're receiving it. What's at the heart? What's at the root of why they're getting dharma? They're manifesting good dharma. Why is that? Okay, it looks like it's in reverse. So let me see. Stop looking for a happiness in the same place you lost it. Yes, that's because someone stopped looking. It's in reverse. Yes, someone passed this test. Okay, in other words, this being in reverse, meaning the person learned it. It was no longer needed to receive the message in the upright. So at the heart, someone has finally stopped looking for happiness in the same places that gave them hell. It's actually insanity. So somebody is manifesting good dharma because they were able to stop that addictive pattern. Going back over and over and over again, whether this was people, places, things, ways of doing and being, whatever that is, habits, you know, somebody got the victory. So the universe is honoring and blessing someone, higher selves, whatever you want to call it, because someone says, no, I'm not going back. I'm not going to keep looking for happiness in the place that gave me hell. It's actually insanity when we say it out loud, right? We look for happiness in the place that we receive hell. Really? So this is a general collective. Whoever's coming in, I'm sorry, I don't have my sign up. It's not Q&A. It's for whoever is manifesting. That's why I said someone's dharma. I'm not going to say yours because you could be a karmic for all I know. So it's someone's. Not saying that you are, but, you know, I'm no fool, right? I'm not oblivious thinking that every single individual coming on here is a divine being. So this is someone's dharma. Love it. Let's get some overall energy. Let's keep pushing. Please help me, light team, because I'm not going to do a 3-hour read. Ooh, yeah. Not today. Still getting ready. I got to do my nails. I'm not finished and I feel like I'm running behind. So I got to keep it on pushing here. All right. Did everything else, all the other girly stuff. So now all I gotta do is take me a bubble bath and do my nails. Okay, clarifying the heart, someone stopped looking for happiness in the places that they received hell. They stop looking, stop expecting. Damn. Ooh, boom. That's like, whoa. Dang, my spirit guides is on tilt. Ooh, I love when this happens because I'm like, ooh, didn't I say it, team? Whoa, whoa. Phoenix rising, baby. Somebody rose from the tower. They rose from the ashes. You don't get to the phoenix unless you go through the destruction. Unless you let the shit hit the fan. Whoa. You know what I'm saying? Ooh, I just said it. Somebody, a phoenix rising. Okay. Oh, shit. 53 breaking down to an 8. Defeated karmics. Defeated karmic cycles. Defeated the ego controlling you. And said, fuck it. Let it all fall. this is me now. Recognize, motherfuckers. No, I'm just kidding. So, somebody's clairvoyant. I have someone that is clairvoyant. Somebody started trusting their guides and their ancestors and their messages with this trust, okay? And so now the universe is honoring your rise, or honoring somebody's rise and shit. Oh, help me, T, because I already feel better. I feel this. Help old Bloomy Bloom. Help me, not for you. Enchanting gifts. Ah. Someone overcame something that people were trying to enchant them with. To get them entrapped, a community. Somebody overcame on a community, maybe, okay, that has some issues with their gifts, their enchanting gifts, was either jealous of their enchanting gifts or had a personal issue with their enchanting gifts. Could have stole something. Let me stop. Help me stay on the lighter side, team, because I see so many storylines here of what happened to get the collective to this rise. They had to go through some shit with some pretty fucked up people, I'm sure. That's always the story, isn't it? All right. Soul Radiance, Phoenix Rising. Somebody's Dharma. One hop, somebody's Dharma lighting. Time for a nap. So, part of y'all's dharma is the universe is giving some of y'all some rest, like a vacation or some shit. After this Phoenix Rising, the universe is honoring you so that you could have a vacation or a break. It could have been from a karmic soulmate or a toxic soulmate or a demoted soulmate that kept, you know what I'm saying, some kind of round and round, same shit, different day. Same story. You know what I'm saying? Round and round we go. Right? So, universe gave you some rest and recuperation, or someone some rest and recuperation. Yeah, recovery. Yes. The universe helps someone to stop observing or to stop watching and caring with observe in reverse about some toxic shit. So now, somebody's finding rest. Somebody's Dharma. Could I get one more for time for a nap? Someone's Dharma. At the heart, somebody stopped looking for something and or someone to make them happy. They stopped looking in those places that were nothing but hell. Okay? That's a lesson in itself. Definition of insanity. Repeating the same things over and over again and expecting it to have some kind of a different outcome. Yes, so the universe is granting somebody a whole new life. It's a whole new world. Say, look at you stretching and shit. You're on a vacation and shit. The universe gave somebody a vacation, stretching, getting them a get down, new get down and shit. They lucky that four-leaf clover effect and shit. Serendipitous. Serendipity is happening, getting all the shit you want. Shit, whoa. Somebody's getting blessed, lucky. Yeah, somebody's Dharma. Yes. Universe supported someone with a deep knowing that if they did something by the book, that they would be supported, honored, and blessed. And since someone did something by the book, the universe saw that. Not saying that they were perfect, but they honored whatever the guidance to the fullness of their ability that they had been given. Okay. So the universe watched and honored that, said, okay, all right, they're trying to do things different now. Okay. With this heart energy right here saying that somebody stopped looking for happiness where they got hell. The universe saw that. Okay. Now they about to rise because they stopped doing that. Now they rise. Now they could rest. Now we're going to help them rest because we're going to give them some support and shit. They ain't going to have to be stressing about no bills. They ain't, motherfucker. They ain't going to have to be going through none of that shit. We finna You know, we finna help them. And I'm only saying that, you guys, because it got time for a nap. So that's telling me the universe was like, okay, they rose, they went through it. So we're going to support them in very unique ways. That lucky clover effect that we just saw, that means whatever you're thinking, you're manifesting, the universe is backing you up. Oh, you need this? Boom. Within reason and balance, but so that you can rest, or someone, after having gone through some major destruction, but to rise as this phoenix. You followed the deep knowing. Somebody followed their knowing. They didn't have the facts in the 3D. They didn't have the blueprint. They didn't have all 12 steps. They didn't have, you know, in the physicality. But someone started trusting their spirit guides and their intuition, so they got honored for it. Okay, or is getting honored for it, right? Yeah, realizing that something was just not for you. Or somebody was starting to finally realize, like, look, this shit ain't for me. I need, oh, look at this 11 card. It could be a twin flame journey with this 6 energy right here, 11 and 6. Someone could have been like, no, this shit ain't fair. These motherfuckers are full of shit. They ain't doing nothing but playing games with karmics. All they always doing is looking for some fucking fortune. Ain't nobody got time for these motherfuckers. So somebody got honored. Yeah. Somebody, yeah. That's how somebody got into the blessed energy. You may wear your hair in a bun. You know what I'm saying? Or you may put it in a ball when you go do yoga. Sitting on your floaty fairy energy and shit. But my fuckers, blessed. It's like, oh. Yeah, after leaving things out, this is a 5 of Pentacle energy. You know, people who always wanted you to feel orphaned, you know what I'm saying? Because they orphaned as fuck. So somebody, you know what I'm saying, just left that out and went to their blessed and said, bye, bye, baby, bye, bye. I'm blessed, bitch. We got blessings right here. See, blessings. Yeah. The universe saw someone had a loyal heart. And that was honored. The universe, ancestors, spirit guides saw that someone had a loyal heart. And because of what they went through with disloyal motherfuckers that brought the towers to get them to this phoenix, we're going to honor them in ways they didn't even imagine. That's somebody's dharma. A change and a win, baby. Yeah. Yeah. A change and a win. Shit turning now. Shit turning the other way. Woo. Woo. People wanted you with bad luck and all this shit is going now to you. Woo. Four-leaf clover effect. Because of that heart, because of following your guidance system, allowing that destruction for somebody, no longer looking for happiness and toxic fucks. And I mean this. I don't care if this is family. I don't care if this is a group, association, a job, a lover, a homie, a friend, a fuck buddy, a husband, a wife, a sister, a brother, a cousin, an auntie. Somebody finally got a damn clue. And stop looking for the source of hell to all of a sudden become the source of happiness, really. Somebody just finally said, light on, ding, ding. No, they fucked up, man. Go on with yourself. With this not for you card, right? With somebody that's like, no. Bye-bye, baby, bye-bye. All right, let's keep pushing because I'll be getting into these readings, y'all. I do, man. Hold on. I be getting into these bad boys. So y'all got to bear with old Bloomy Bloom. I be getting excited, too. I be like, oh, shit. And I don't feel 4 hours I done sat here because I'm all digging and shit. Well, fuck. I'm asking my team to help me with that. Because I'll be on one. I be like, ooh, I want to know the answer to that. Give me that. Give me that. Give me that. Ooh, who this hoe? I be like, who that? shit, because I'm so nosy. Okay. For those of you sending likes and roses, thank you. I thought I just looked up at the screen and saw something because I can't barely see from my angle, but thank you if somebody did. Yay! All right. Ooh, someone's Dharma. Phoenix rising. Some powerful motherfuckers. This someone is. Okay, it's some powerful motherfuckers, I have to say it. Okay, sorry about that. I'm going to take the filter off of the light because I think the filters may slow things down as well with the special effects and stuff. So I'm just going to leave that out, though I enjoy it thoroughly. Yeah, but whoever the someones are, because you got to kind of go through, you really have to successfully get through, not just survive through, not just, you know, with your head in the sand and it's another day, or, you know, you put your fingers in your ears and close your eyes and like, la, 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 la. Like, no, that's not Phoenix rising, motherfuckers. Okay. Phoenix rising, motherfuckers face shit. Okay. They stare it in the eyes. You know what I'm saying? For lack of better words, they're not putting their head in the sand. Okay. They're not closing their eyes and pretending like things aren't there. They deal with it. Okay. This is why they're here. It ain't because they hid somewhere and then they say, oh, I'm the Phoenix Rising, didn't deal with shit. No, they faced the dark side of the soul. They faced the truth about whatever that shit was and let a tower fall and stop trying to, you know, put tape and glue and hangers. Like old school, you know, you got to be pretty old to even know what I'm about to say. But it was a time in history where we would use hangers to try to like stick it in an antenna to be like, you know, to try to get a better reception and shit. And then, you know, if you came from poverty or if you came from meager means, you know, you become notorious for trying to put tape on everything. You know what I'm saying? And that's bypassing what the real issue is. And so whoever these Phoenix Rising folks are, y'all didn't try to put tape on it. Okay. You didn't try to like get a hanger. You know what I'm saying? Y'all just dealt with this shit, whoever it is, right? Like, no, let's deal with this shit. Light team, let's clarify. We have somebody stop looking for happiness where there's hell. We got Phoenix Rising. We got rest at the heart. You guys gave them a break, a nap, a vacation, a deep knowing. What do we have here? Oh, boy. They fell on time for a nap. A community. Somebody got away from a community. A karmic community. Left a community of folks. Somebody finally was able to do it. So the universe honored. Maybe this was difficult, okay, for somebody with that round for round. So someone finally just like, you know what? Uh-uh. Yeah, because here's justice. Yeah. This is a karma card. Justice. Something was not right. Something wasn't balanced. Something wasn't fair with this community, whatever, whoever these people are. The universe could have put them to rest. Ooh. Oh. That's a whole nother reading. The universe could have put them to rest. Shit, fuck it. For some of y'all, for somebody, like, uh-uh, this shit crazy. Night, 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 night. Sleepy time. Yeah, somebody got free. Mm-hmm. Overcame a toxic community. Yeah. Because something went right about something in somebody's fortune. Somebody ended up getting judged. Something was karmic. Yep. Somebody was doing something because of unexpected income. It was hidden dishonor. Something about a death. Okay. Deaths or a death or putting things to an end. Something was off. A death of a child or attempting to. take something from a child or attempting to put an end to a child or someone young. That was dumb. Yep, here it is. It's a false person. Someone overcame that. Someone became the phoenix rising. Somebody overcame all that energy. Wow. Behind lovers, siblings. Oh, my team, Wise Community in Reverse, and help me to keep it pushing. Mature woman is in reverse. Oh boy. An older woman that was older but immature, or an older woman that died, or older woman. Their Dharma. Why is this related to Dharma team? Who is this? The collective's Dharma is there, the phoenix rising. So they overcame something. Something to do with this community. They either left a community, something here with this nap energy. Who is she? Who is this mature woman? Is this mature woman in reverse? Is this representative of a karmic mother, lover, a karmic feminine? Is this mature woman a karmic feminine? Benevolent energy, please. Grandma, light team, source, higher self. Is this mature woman in reverse representative of a karmic feminine energy? Please and thank you. Is this a karmic feminine energy? Is this a, yep, I knew it. Damn. Okay. Is this, okay, so what happened with this nap then? Is this representative of a breakup or someone leaving a family? Is this representative of a breakup or someone leaving the karmic family? Is this representative of a breakup or someone leaving a karmic family? Light only, benevolence only? It's not. Wait, it's changing. Hold on. What the hell? Grandma, source, higher self, by the fire. It's time for a nap, representative of some type of end of relationship with these karmic energies. A breakup or an end. Is this time for a nap, representative of a breakup or an end? Some type of ending with these karmic. There it is. Boom. Boom. There it is. I was waiting for it. Yes. So as I was saying, whoever's got the Dharma is because someone finally was successful with breaking up or leaving a karmic family. Okay. Lover, family, some kind of connection with karmic energies. We have a mature woman reversed. This could be a karmic mother, okay, or an older person that's karmic. And then a karmic, you know, siblings, children, you know, community, social circle, okay. So, yeah, work, yeah, people who were doing toil and labor, doing spells and rituals, or doing something with someone's work. Yeah, pertaining to a wealthy man, sudden wealth, message of concern. Okay, yeah, so somebody got some Dharma because somebody walked away, so that's good, right? Yay, let's keep it pushing. Okay, so this is the final message is right here, whoa, and then they're going to get them another spiritual F, so help me, my team. Because please, please, please. This is good. This is a good reading. Dharma for getting through. Somebody did. Okay. Left a family, a lover. Some toxic feminine energy, as well as some type of toxic community. okay, that, yeah, someone was investing in over and over again, Seven of Pentacles, they could have invested, someone was investing 7+ months, okay, 7+ months, could have been 7 years for some of you, but 7+ months or 17 months, okay, in these toxic families. All right, King of Wands, yeah. All right, team, so let's get the tarot. Someone's Dharma here. So how is the universe supporting or helping and blessing somebody for ending something here, for no longer seeking happiness where there was nothing but hell? Okay. What is someone's Dharma here for this? Because we got their Phoenix rising, deep knowing. Somebody walked away, let go, boom, boom, boom. What is their Dharma? What's their Dharma? Magician is in the reverse. Why? Their Dharma is that they cannot be manipulated. Someone can't be manipulated anymore as a part of your Dharma. Another part of the Dharma is spell work is not going to work. People who are doing rituals, magic, and all that right here, these people aren't going to be able, since we clarified it right here, the Dharma is, it was revoked. It was returned to sender. If they were doing spell work, it was revoked. If they were just simply manipulative, sneaky and snaky, then it was revoked. It was returned to sender. They're not going to be able to slither and snake their way. That's somebody's Dharma, free from spell work. Yep, because somebody left it out in the cold. Five of Pentacles. Left those individuals out. Stop playing with spell work, maybe, with those individuals. Yeah. Yeah, block. Somebody block these people. Somebody's Dharma is, first and foremost, they're no longer confused. And these people's black magic and spells and manipulation is blocked. Okay. Yeah, ooh, it's a strong block. Like that shit going back with the vengeance. Okay. Ooh, that's somebody's Dharma. Their Dharma is this shit bounced back. Bounce. Why? Because somebody walked away. Somebody finally figured out that your defense is in walking away and cutting ties. Somebody figured it out. Wow. Yeah. Yeah, reject it. Yes, look at this. Somebody's Dharma is that they're free. They rejected these cops, okay? They've blocked manipulation, rejecting these people's cups, okay, or no longer care, and possibly going to some other wish fulfillment here. Yeah, they cut somebody out. Whoever got Dharma, they stepped into a Queen of Swords and was like, the Queen of Swords, she cut shit out, even if it's a man. They cut shit out that's not serving here. Somebody's Dharma, lighting. Somebody's Dharma as a result of walking away from whatever this was. Yeah, Six of Swords. The universe and your guys is taking somebody to calmer waters. Six of Swords. You could have moved across the water, across the nation, across the country. You know. Yeah. Sailed on away. That's somebody's Dharma, is they get to get free of whoever these motherfuckers were. These people can't control them. It could have been a toxic emperor in reverse, which is a narc, tyrant motherfucker. And don't get it twisted. This could be a girl. Okay? Just letting y'all know right now. An emperor in reverse is the definition of a narc, somebody who is a bully. They're a tyrant. They're bossy, controlling. Okay? Yeah, somebody, yeah, moving life onto karma waters after having dealt with an arc. Somebody was married to a narc. Somebody finally said, bye bye, baby, bye bye, was married to a narc and a narc family together. They were all together, the narc and their narc family, and it was one big narc party. That kept them narky stuck. Ooh, that was hell. I bet whoever knows, ooh, child. Somebody's dharma is like, ooh, bye bye, baby, bye bye. Somebody's dharma is they free and shit. The dharma is your spirit guides, freedom, motherfucker. Six of swords. Nine of wands. Selling away from doing the same thing over and over again. Selling away from mental patience. No longer dealing with folks that keep you in a state of angst. People who do the same shit to you over and over again, causing your head to hurt and shit. With the bandage and shit. You know what I'm saying? Folks that's constantly trying to take a hit at your esteem. Somebody is free from these kind of people. The universe said because somebody finally started holding back Four of Pentacles, investing time, energy, resources, and attention into these types of individuals. So the freedom is a part of somebody's dharma. The freedom from spell work. The freedom from being spell bound. Feeling bound and confined and not knowing why. To a group, a person, a lover, or a community, someone is free now. That's the dharma. Because as we're before, as long as people were staying stuck and connected and they couldn't go through the Phoenix Rising, they were susceptible to these people's manipulation or their spell work. Okay. The confusion, the illusion, the game playing. Right? Somebody is free. We got Eight of Swords in reverse. Your dharma is you are free. You're not stuck in your head in a self-made imprisonment. Okay? That's somebody's dharma. Somebody is free. Somebody ain't gonna go to jail, motherfucker. Like, somebody could have got themselves out of something just on time. They could have got themselves free just on time for they don't be the one. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, ooh, if I keep doing this shit over and over again, nine of wands, with these motherfuckers, I'm going to be on clank, clank. You know what I'm saying? And upright and shit, boom. Somebody finally got a clue. It's like, nah. Universe is like, okay, cool. Well, your dharma then is you get to move into karma waters. You get a break. You get a rest. You get to be free from spell work and being manipulated. As long as you stay here with this karmic feminine and this karmic community, you were going to be susceptible to whatever their fuck shit was. And we tried to tell you that. So somebody finally got a clue. Somebody got a clue. Somebody's dharma. Ooh, Two of Swords. Two of Swords is crossing this. Somebody is blocking. It fell over onto this, the family and the karmic. Huh. Ooh, somebody see the truth. I was waiting for it. I was just about to say it before I looked at the bottom of the deck. Okay, so someone knows that they were blind before. Okay, they were confused. They know who was causing the confusion. Okay, with landing on that karmic feminine and this karmic community. Someone knows the truth. And that's how somebody got free. So what happened was someone who decided just to follow their guidance, the universe, a part of their dharma, was that as they detached, right, blocked, detached, rejected, sold away, the universe, sorry about that, provided them with truth and clarity. They had a confused mind as long as they stayed connected to the karmic feminine and that karmic community. So the universe showed them the truth when they walked away, but they couldn't get it before. Wow, that's dope. Like, you're not going to get it as long as you're fucking them. So stop asking. You're not going to get it as long as you're hiding for them, covering for them, investing in them. So stop asking. You're not going to get it as long as you're sticking your fingers in your ears, closing your eyes and going la, 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 la. So stop asking. You're not going to get it until you follow your guidance system. Then you become a phoenix rising and you'll be able to see clearly who was behind, what was keeping you confused the whole time, what you were refusing to see the entire time. So somebody got blessed with seeing clearly and the truth about a family, a community, a karmic feminine, okay? Somebody got blessed. It could be anybody, you guys. Four of swords. Somebody, four, yeah. Here's that rest energy. Somebody is getting some rest. They're meditating. They're healing. They're recovering after having following their guidance to let go and walk away. Right? That's the Dharma. You get to heal. You get to recover. Closed out a cycle. Learned a karmic lesson. Finally learned how to close out cycles. And no longer watching the motherfuckers. Observe and reverse. No longer watching these karmic people. No longer being concerned about them watching. No longer watching somebody's fortune or being concerned about it. Yeah. It's an ending to that. Lessons learned. Wow. The world. This was major, you guys. So this is why somebody's getting some Dharma. The world is the last card in tarot. Okay? And then you go into after tarot. But in traditional tarot, this is the end, meaning that you cycle through all of the phases and stages of tarot and have learned how to properly close out cycles, put things to an end, and move on and have a whole new beginning, going back to zero, to the full, on a whole new journey, not repeating the same cycles, right? Aquarius, Scorpio, Taurus, Capricorn could be involved. Okay. Yep. Somebody's Dharma. Ooh. Ah. And now it flies out. Ace of Swords. Universe, this is Source's hand. Sticking out there. Says, y'all can try if you may, but here I come, my fuckers. Truth. Truth and clarity. The sword of truth. Ooh, somebody. Ooh, child. So now, universe is giving somebody a whole... The wheel is turning to somebody's favor now because, well... Okay, somebody could have spoke their truth. Somebody could have spoke a truth and ended something with the world. Somebody with that nap and spoke the truth is like, bye-bye. Mm-hmm. Universe, help me out, motherfucker. Somebody's Dharma, help me out, team. Whoever this collective is, someone's good karma. Someone's good karma for becoming the phoenix. The phoenix rising. Aw. So now somebody fits into manifesting the two of cups. A spiritual union. Ooh. Ooh. So somebody can either get some balance. Yeah, whoa. Yeah, somebody got them a plan and shit. Whoop. Universe. I'm sorry. It's just, it's kind of funny. Like, I can feel the energy of what someone went through, right? To get to the Phoenix Rising. So that's on whoever these people are. They're a little bit funny or kind of humorous in their own way. Like a dark, edgy humor. Whoever went through it. And they like, whoop, shit. You know what I'm saying? So they finally got here, right? They was like, shit, fuck me. So now it's like, whoop, I got the truth and shit about Two of Cups, high level soulmate, spiritual union, cosmic union. Whoop. Shoes, this is what I'm finna do. I know a direction that I want to go in, Three of Wands, right? That's somebody's thought pattern. Okay. I know what direction I want to go in. I'm waiting for my ships to come in and shit. Whoop. I done made my choice. And I'm finna offer my Page of Pentacles. I got me one pentacle left after dealing with these dizzy hoes. I got one pentacle left after walking away from these dizzy family members or, you know, whatever the situation was. I got me a pentacle. I'm going to be of integrity. I'm coming in with truth. I'm coming in with communication here. But it's going to be solid. It's going to be truth. It's going to be integral. As small as it may be. But I'm coming. So that's somebody's dharma. The universe is going to honor that first someone. That's someone's dharma for finally walking away from something here. That they're going to be able to rebuild or recover their fortune. The wheel now is going to turn back into the upright position after having freeing themselves from some karmic stuff. Okay? Karmic stuff and people. Yeah, Queen of Swords. Ooh. Oh, shit. Yeah, somebody's coming towards a Queen of Swords. Okay, the Queen of Swords could be a Divine Feminine. Eight of Wands is traveling. Okay, let me just clarify who is the Queen of Swords here in the upright. In this context, someone's dharma is this Queen of Swords representative of Divine Feminine. Benevolent energy only, please, team. Source. Spirit guides, is this representative of Divine Feminine? Queen of Swords upright, is this Divine Feminine energy in this context? Queen of Swords, is she representative of Divine Feminine in this context? Queen of Swords, is this it's Divine Feminine. Is Divine Feminine in her form of sword? Okay, she's in a Queen of Swords energy. But the Queen of Swords, Divine Feminine, could have moved on. Also with this Eight of Wands, but someone is like, they getting their motorcycle. So look, Queen, Divine Feminine, you get to move on, right? This is your dharma. If you were like walking away from a karmic family, a karmic mother, a karmic community, right? Represented in the reading, if you did that, then this is you. You're the Queen of Swords as a Divine Feminine. The universe is backing you up. You may be famous. You may be traveling. You may be seen with this Eight of Wands. You go in places rapidly. This is fast. It's a fast energy. It's fire. You may be very fiery right now. Okay. But you also are swordsy. Okay. Because the Queen of Swords is in a matter of fact energy. She puts the emotion aside and she does what's necessary. So if people were fucked up, she gets in the sword. Like, she has her sword of truth, and she said, bitch. Okay? That's her energy. She'd be like, bitch. Know who you talking to. Know who you dealing with. Because we finna use the sword. That's what we finna do. No fuck up. Okay? So she can, so she can move forward. But, yeah, so that's your dharma, Divine Feminine, since you came out. You know, from dealing with these karmic, you know, feminines and fucked up my fuckers. Shoot. Whoa. What else we got? Somebody's dharma? Divine Feminine is the phoenix. Ah, look at this. It came out in reverse. Thank goodness. Your dharma is your heart. Is healed. Okay. Your dharma is healing from a broken heart from what these people did. From the devil. From the devil. These devilish motherfuckers. Okay. You're healing. You're healed. Source. Ooh, Source was right behind. Look at this shit. Like, bitch. Like, Source is like, you look at the cards. It's like, bitch. We see your toxic bitch ass. I don't know what you thought. P people trying to claim you were of the devil, people that were trying to fuck with your stability, base unstable ass. Yeah. A crazy ass emperor or a crazy ass narky motherfuckers and shit. Crazy fucks. Yeah. Your healing. They wanted to make you sad and shit. Five of Cups. And that's why you guys left these people. They were controlling. They were tyrants. They were the devil. And they could have been pretentious, self-righteous type too. Fake ass motherfuckers. Because the Hierophant could also represent someone who, you know what I'm saying, could be trying to go about talking about God all the time, but toxic as fuck. You know what I'm saying? And then trying to project the shit onto the divine being because they really connected to source as opposed to just quoting some shit. Somebody is Dharma. You free. You get to heal. You ain't brokenhearted no more. Behind no dizzy ass, toxic ass devils. Woo! Yeah, that's somebody's Dharma. Somebody's Dharma? Yeah. Okay, so somebody's going to get a communication about, here's the Ten of Cups. In reverse, here's that karmic family again. Somebody may get some kind of communication here. That's going to be a part of somebody's Dharma. A family member. It could be a family member or someone pertaining to or knowing something about. Okay. Yeah. What someone was doing to keep somebody stuck. I have the Hanged Man and the Lover. Somebody could go to jail or be going to jail. And somebody could get a message about it if there was some type of illegal activity. And the Dharma is someone's going to get a message about it, or because I do got the Hanged Man, it's a possibility. It's possible. It just depends, you know, on the situation. I mean, there's some kind of a communication though. That's going to be somebody's Dharma. Yeah. Five of Wands, people who were secretly competing. Okay, with divine feminine. Oh, that's a pretty heart. I just saw that. Oh, I wish I could have took a screenshot. Someone was secretly competing with divine feminine where they don't compare. Why, lighting? Just, oh, what the fuck is wrong with people? Lord. Anyway, let me get off that. Okay. Somebody's Dharma. Yeah, the Dharma is, it's over. Five of Swords reverse. Somebody is free from gossipy, low vibratory people. Five of Swords, bye bitches. It's over. The gossip, the pettiness, you know what I'm saying? Fighting with these motherfuckers, caring, and even talking about somebody's Dharma is like, all this shit is done. It's just done. Somebody defeated these karmics. It's done. Somebody won. Yeah, and moving on. Somebody defeated a whore. Shit. I got Knight of Wands. Somebody going on with their get down. Yeah. Getting fortune to turn back in their favor after a loss of sorts, right? After, you know, not getting no real victory and success with people of the past here. Six of Cups. Somebody's finally let go of what was being held to them. A sibling, a family member, a past lover. Right? Somebody defeated they ass. Phoenix rising. Here's the Emperor. Boom. Who all? Let me fence the... Y'all, old Bloomy Bloom, is fencing to ask about who this. Oh, the narky energy done came out. A narky hoe. that came out. Let me find out. Light team. Who this? I'm just to find out because I think this is DM1. I think this is DM1 and or the holes and families is representative of her. Light team. Is this here Empress? Is this Emperor in reverse? Benevolent energy only. Is this representative of the karmic feminine and the karmic community? We need to clarify. I want to narrow this down. Is this Emperor in reverse representative of either the effects or the energy of this karmic feminine and karmic community in the reading? Is this Emperor in reverse representative or the energy of the karmic feminine and the karmic community? Emperor reverse, karmic feminine, karmic community. Yes or no, please, team. Emperor in reverse. Truth, truth, light, truth, benevolence. Is this Emperor representative of the karmic, feminine, and community? Back me up, team. Benevolent energy only. Violet fire. Expose the truth. They don't want it. I already know what's happening. Who is this Emperor in reverse? Is this karmic feminine and karmic community? Is this the 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 karmic feminine and karmic community? Grandma, amp this up. Is this the karmic feminine and karmic community? There it is. Is this the karmic feminine and karmic community? This Emperor reverse light team. Is this the karmic feminine and the karmic community? Is this the karmic feminine? And yeah, there it is. That's what I thought. Yep. I wanted to find out. I needed to find out because this could be DM1. So that's, you know, I'm like, who is this? I wanted to know what it represents. That's why I told y'all don't get stuck on gender. This represents, in this context of the reading, this is the karmic feminine and the community. The horrors that use sex and passions that was causing somebody to do things without thinking. So somebody's dharma is they defeated these narky people, okay? These people right here, they defeated them. Free from them, defeated them, all that healing, my parka, three of swords reverse, cutting shit out. This is divine feminine. Divine feminine, this could be you that's free from all of this, okay? Someone's dharma and getting blessed. Healing, getting some kind of information. And yeah, five of wands. Now it comes out. Somebody's dharma is, it fell onto community. Somebody is now holding back from the community. The dharma is that either you divine feminine, you got the victory, you're holding back from this community that's always trying to fight with you, secretly compete where they don't compare, always doing shit. Okay. No more investment there. Something is being held back from them. The universe could be holding something back from them too. Okay. Something that they were fighting for, something they stole, chances are. Yeah. Yeah. Because they were keeping something from, here's divine feminine. Here she is. So your dharma, you're getting some dharma for what these people stole. Somebody is getting dharma for what these people stole. People who were trying to secretly compete where they don't compare. people who could have possibly stole somebody's work, somebody's content, somebody's ideas, somebody's legacy, or somebody's inheritance, or they could, it's something. So and the universe saw it. That's why I said people dizzy as fuck, man. Just dizzy all day long. They really thought. Yeah. Somebody that was codependent, Nine of Pentacles, tried to claim that the Divine Feminine was codependent. It was them all along. Oh, how we must learn the hard way sometime. It was them all along. Them all the fuck along. They were causing burdens and blockages and then trying to say Divine Feminine was codependent, but they bitch asses was doing shit. Yeah. Lion holes, Seven of Swords, thank you. Tried to say Divine Feminine was. No. Flip that. Somebody's Dharma. I told you. I told y'all the universe was going to give you something. I knew it. I was like, they don't have a clue. I knew it. I'm like, wait for it. Wait for it. Because somebody had the kahuna to walk the fuck away from this toxic shit, even walking away from when a motherfucker's stealing bitch asses, trying to compete where they don't compare, secretly trying to look like you, talk like you, walk like you, dress like you, act like you, be you. I don't think so. You can't be me. We're here to be us, not someone else. This is a lesson a lot of people learn the long, slow, and hard way. Somebody getting a pinnacle. Somebody getting a new beginning from the universe. Sources still said they thought they stole some shit, but they don't run shit. The universe is vast. They curse themselves with a curse fucking with you. Stealing from a divine, trying to kill a divine was ill-advised. And as I said, that you are the legacy, Divine Feminine. It's yours. Ten of Pentacles. We got the Ace and we got the Ten. The legacy lies with the divine. Whatever else motherfuckers did is going to crumble and be cursed with a curse. It's going to be a source of hell. The Ten of Pentacles belong to her. The true Divine Feminine, bitches. She's strong. Yeah, the universe is granting somebody some major strength here and some strong, look at this energy. This is somebody's Dharma. Can't nobody do nothing about it. All they can do is fuck with karmics and low vibratory individuals who don't want to sin and live the cursed life together. But they can't do nothing. Ooh. Ooh, child. Yeah. Somebody coming towards you. Awesome. Divine Feminine. If you Divine Feminine, either somebody coming towards you or you getting on your horse and shit. Whoa. You heard me? You getting on your horse and shit? Shoot. Whoa. Your Dharma is you get strength. You fencing to get you some strong dividends and shit. Your legacy is solid as fuck. Okay? It's solid. It ain't built on spell work and thievery. It ain't built on that. It ain't built on fraud and sucking and fucking. You didn't have to steal it from your sister and brother, Divine Feminine. It's legit. You ain't have to copy and paste somebody else's shit because Divine Feminine, you too legit to quit. Now I'm just playing. Balance is getting restored. Woo, Dharma. Phoenix Rat. Yeah, motherfuckers. Oh, you know the truth. Somebody's in a high priestess energy. Keeper of knowledge. You know you defeated they ass. It fell over onto the Five of Swords. Reverse. You know it. Yo, oh shit. You know. What kind of shit? Yeah, child. Because they're under judgment. Ooh, ouch. We got justice, judgment. Three. Here goes the three mile. Here the community. Ooh. Aries. Fool in reverse. You know the secrets. That's somebody's dharma. Because we're asking about dharma, right? Interesting. Keep it pushing. 19. Then we're going to do our final messages. Dharma. Someone's dharma. They got that phoenix. Oh, page of wands. Somebody's getting news, but it's bad news for the devil. I got the devil at the bottom, so it's bad news for the devil. It's someone else's dharma. Wow, this is interesting. It fell over here. Oh, the devil is concerned. Look, the devil is concerned. The devil is concerned. That's when you know you're a bad bitch. The devil. It fell on top of concern. The devil is concerned. Bad news, okay? The devil is concerned about the good news, okay? That's, you know they're the devil if they're concerned about somebody else's good news, right? Or because it means their ass is going to go to jail or they're not going to be able to benefit off of somebody's shit anymore. The devil is concerned of God. Source is saying, oh, you want to play this game. Okay. You want to walk around acting like you were of me. I'm about to expose you. That's what you wanted to do? You wanted to twist this shit up, toxic motherfuckers? Attachments and shit? We gonna show the truth here. Since you wanted, you wanted to play with a divine being? Ill advised. This was dumb. Yeah, because look at what's happening. So somebody's dharma is they get to move on from these devils. These toxic attachments, these toxic addictions, these toxic connections, these toxic marriages and shit. Somebody was married to the damn devil. Shit. They were next to each other. Somebody was married to the devil, a bad news devil, married to the bad news devil. So somebody is free. Somebody's dharma is they get to move on and have victory and success and have rapid accelerated growth, right? And get to get into their happiness here because they finally got themselves free. It could be divine feminine that got free from a toxic couple, a toxic, you know what I'm saying? Motherfuckers, mother and father, a toxic, you know, jealous, obsessed couple and shit. Obsessing and shit. They weirdos, motherfuckers. You know what I'm saying? Want to be the... What the kind of shit is this? Go get a life. That's how I know people be messed up. I'm like, oh yeah. I'm like, because you, It's like you too invested, bitch. You know what I'm saying? Like, how about you go... Get a clue. Because you try to fuck up with the divine shit, your shit coming down. Oh, it's coming. You want to target the divines and they shit? Watch your shit die. Watch it. Just watch it. Watch it slowly crumble. Because you were warned. Somebody's going to get some good news because somebody is getting free from the devil. The devil. and going to their happiness. Yeah. Over it. No more betrayals. Stop. Somebody stop dealing with people who are hell-bent on betraying them time after time. With their wand, their bad news wand and shit. Bad news wand, bad news hoo-ha. You know what I'm saying? Fuck buddies and fuck holes and shit. People that use sex as a weapon. Sex to get in and control somebody. Yeah. Not somebody's wish fulfillment. Trying to make somebody sad. Trying to mess up with somebody's wish fulfillment. They gonna fry. The Dharma is... You guys are getting balance restored, okay? This may be you, Divine Feminine, getting balance restored. And here comes somebody who loves you, King of Cups. Here he is. Yeah, he finna choose you. Somebody done said, girl, what you talking about? Shoot, I got love for you and I got fire for you. Ooh, King of Cups. And King of Wands, he wants. So they must have come in. They're like, whoa, shit, this shit was hidden. Shit, they hid this shit, bitch. Right? Whoa. They was afraid of it, but now they're like, Empress. Divine Feminine. Shit, where you going? Where you at, girl? Here we come. We coming to get you. Somebody's Dharma is y'all. Either way. Collective, whoever you are, because of your obedience, you're manifesting fire, passion, and love. People who are coming in that's gonna love you and have passion for you. And honey, you ain't gonna have to fucking compete with no low vibrational fucking Zodis pick and save my fucker. You ain't gonna have to do none of that. Okay? You ain't gonna have to do no riddle me this big shit. Motherfucker, you ain't gonna have to. Yeah, justice. You're manifesting justice for yourself here. The universe stepped in and said, oh, we told motherfuckers balance will be restored. So, okay. Somebody's gonna get their Dharma while the others get the other shit. Woo, source says absolutely. You guys are manifesting higher level commitments, spiritual unions, people that you ain't gotta try to fucking pull wisdom teeth to see your point of view and fucking accept you and all that. You're manifesting shit that's coming that way. That's called Dharma. Okay, you ain't manifesting shit where people believe karmic dizzy asses. And then wonder why they life destroyed and then come. You know what I'm saying? And then come looking at you. It's like, nah, motherfucker. But that's what you thought was legit, though. That's what you thought. So, you know, we'll try to tell your whole ass. You know what I'm saying? Don't be mad at me. Ace of Cups. You guys are manifesting love. You love yourself. This is why the universe supported you. This is Dharma. The universe said, great, now we're going to pour love. You're finally going to manifest people who are going to pour back into you, finally. And it ain't going to be laced with some damn fucking hoodoo and shit. It ain't going to be some fuck shit. Yeah, putting things to an end, collective, whoever these Dharma is for, it saves you from happening to have your towers destroyed, you know, the things that you built on a solid foundation, but from dealing with fucked up people, our attachments also affects our manifestation. So whether you built something on solid ground or not, if you're attached to toxic karmic energy, you still end up in towers. I had to learn that the hard way. The universe is be screaming like, get the fuck away from these motherfuckers. They're not your friend. They don't like you. They're trying to steal from you. They're trying to secretly compete with you. They're plotting and scheming behind your back. Get the fuck away from them, because even though you are building from a solid foundation, they're karmics. So they're going to fuck up in your energy and sabotage what you're creating. Get out. Right? So whoever's getting this Dharma, realize, like, look, I'll get some introspection. You know what I'm saying? Could be a King of Pentacles. Now here, damn, he in every reading. I done seen almost all the kings, the Emperor motherfucker out here and shit. Whoop, Divine Masculine may be involved, but yeah, King of Pentacles got him some perspective. He didn't. He said about, you know, what maybe somebody did in the past to overt a tower, but somebody's realizing that putting an end to things also has averted moving forward what they're trying to build in life, okay? Whoever that's for. So that's why somebody's getting self-love and love. Yay. Okay. Now, that's enough. Somebody's Dharma, somebody getting love, somebody getting justice and shit. Whoa. Somebody getting the Ten of Pentacles, the Ace of Pentacles, bitch. Somebody getting, whoa, Two of Cups, C-Cups. This is beautiful. Wheel of Fortune and shit, fucking truth, aces. Shoot, ships coming in, motherfucker. Communication, Pentacles. Freedom, Eight of Swords is in reverse. Defeating the Narcs energy is here. Defeated, motherfuckers. Motherfucker, defeated. Okay. I love it. Somebody's Dharma. Yay. Okay. Now, let's get to the final messages with the two decks. Okay. We started the heart of someone's Dharma is because someone finally stopped looking for happiness in the same place in which they lost it. Someone finally stopped looking for happiness in the source and place of hell. Okay? So this is why they are this. Phoenix. I'm going to leave this energy out. Somebody became a phoenix because they stopped doing that. Okay? Cool. So let's get the final messages. Guidance, advice, or what someone needs to know. Someone's Dharma. Final messages. Guidance. Excuse me. Advice. Or what somebody needs to know. I feel good, y'all. You're protected. Look at this shit. I cut the deck. It says here. I'm going to show you. First, it says, let me see if you guys can see it. It says, you already doing it, honey. So stop overthinking and just keep facing your true north. This came out yesterday. Keep moving forward, no matter what nasty energy you feel like the lower vibrator fuckers are sending you, no matter what you're initially going through, because when you first walk away from toxicity, you still got Stockholm syndrome and trauma bondings, and you have to kind of live and heal through all of that. But if you're really this Phoenix rising energy, the universe is just saying, okay, it's all right. You don't need to overthink anything. You're already doing what you need to be doing, but just keep doing it. Keep at it, okay? And then as you keep at it, understand that you're protected. Okay? As you cut these cords here, call back your power. So if you've walked away and cut cords, start calling back your power from these narky motherfuckers. Okay, call back your energy and power, cut the cords, go online if you want to do a ritual, listen to some frequencies. I did that in the Akashic Records today. It was some powerful shit. On behalf of me and my son, I went in. Okay, one plan. I called some shit out, asked my guys to handle some. I went there. I sure did. I went there. But it was a beautiful energy, though, that came through for me and my son. And it changed everything. I felt the whole energy in me. And I saw it in him. Because every time I'll do something at proxy for him, then I immediately almost see his shift, even though he don't know what happened. And the environment, it just shifted. I was like, ooh, this is why I like dealing with the Akash. But I called in them heavy hitters. I was like, I'm gonna need y'all. Back me up. But I was on fire too. Like when I was, that happens when I do the energy sessions. Sometimes when I do energy sessions, I start heating up. Like I feel my whole body gets hot. And then, you know, tingly, and it's a trip. Anyway, so yeah, just call back your energy and power. You know, I have a little thing here on TikTok, a little short where I say something like, I call back my energy, I call back my power. I call back my soul fragments in this hour, like I repeat it. And then I say something like, from all directions of time and space, from all beings, places, and realities, I alchemize and disintegrate, transmute all toxic, malevolent, narcissistic, karmic energies. Over and over, over and over, over and over, right? But knowing that you're protected because I say this all the time to people. It took me a long time to realize it. The protection is divine, but it's through your alignment. So when someone decides to follow their guidance system and, you know what I'm saying, cut ties, clear their energy, raise their vibration, ascend, heal, and wake up, this is where you get overcoming power from shit the people do. But when we still playing in the devil's pen, you know, pig bin, then no, you don't. The protection is only to a degree and for so long designed to help divine beings get out. But there is a point of no return. Like, well, it's like, well, okay, by your divine choice, you're doing this. So you can't clean and then go jump back in the pig's bin. Now, you know, you're creating your own karmic circle, you know, cycle over and over again. And so you're just making yourself stuck. But the protection comes in when we just keep moving forward, no matter how it feels initially, until you get used to being free. Until you get used to doing things differently, until you stop caring about their, you know, the backlash. Because you can feel their nasty energy. How dare you not be controlled by me? How dare you not? You know what I'm saying? So you feel their shit, but you get more and more powerful. I promise you this. Where when you sense it, you know, after a while, it's almost like you boomerang it and shit. You step back into your energy. And it gets more and more quick because you ain't dilly-dallying with they ass. You're not playing with them. You know where the energy is coming from, right? So I had to learn that. I practice this stuff daily. I don't be playing. As soon as some weird shit, somebody calls some weird off shit like motherfucker stupid and shit. Because people will trip. Like, it's funny. I'm like, I'm like, motherfucker. I'm like, late teen, grandma, who, whatever the fuck they just said and chanted and shit, bitch, whoop they ass with it. If they said some shit about when she pick up the phone, yeah, when she pick up the phone and you finna get the shit you said, that's what you finna do because you fucked with the wrong one today. When she picks up the phone, she's sending you your energy. That's what's going to happen. Do you understand now? Light team, final messages. Those who are getting Dharma, final guidance, please. HIGHVIBE, benevolence, light team, grandma, step in here. Ancestors, step in here. Final guidance. Light, violet, fire. Boom. Boom. Yeah, baby. Break the chain. Yeah. Aww. See, look. this. This is, I'm so happy. Okay. This is, man, break the chain. Ancestral patterns, healing, and rewriting the future. I did this in the Akashic Records today. That's crazy. What lights you up, starseed? So somebody's a starseed, okay? The guidance is for somebody to start focusing on what lights them up versus the fuck nuts. What lights you up? And guess what? You're a pillar of light. Your vibration is rising. You are the fucking oracle. Recognize motherfuckers. Lighting. Thank you. Source. Thank you. Ancestors, spirit guides, thank you. You are a pillar of light. Look at this shit. Motherfucker. Like, see, they didn't fuck with her. They didn't mess with the wrong motherfucker. They didn't mess up. Your vibration. Ooh, they didn't mess up. That's why I'm like, ooh, that's not good for them. But it is good for those of you who are getting this Dharma. Your vibration is rising. You are the oracle. That's why I don't like you. That's why I try to shut you up, man. That's why I try to demonize you. That's why I try to project their toxic fuck shit on you. Because you expose their fuck shit. Starseed. I don't like ya. Because their illusions shatter. I wanted to kill ya. And then try to act like they you and take your seat. Oh, you will not. Cursed with a curse. Motherfucker. Protected. You're protected, man. The universe is like, oh, you're a pillar of light. You're increasing your vibration. Somebody broke the chain and shit or being guided to. I did, like I said, I did it today on behalf of me and my son. I went into the Akash. And not only did I go into the Akash, I made the decision. See, this whole reading was about people who finally made the decision to do something here. It's these decisions and actions that changes trajectories and patterns. It's not quoting some scripture. It's not going about acting loving, but being the devil, truly. It's not stealing to get rich and then acting like you broke some shit. It's not taking something from a divine which puts the curse of Judas on you. And trying to act like you victorious. It's by being different. Dealing with the root of the wounds of the ancestry. And if the ancestry bloodline was that of whores and thieves and con artists and pimps, someone had to break it. And not with fraud and illusion. If it was being negligent and abusive and abandonment, domestic violence within one's own family, drunks and addicts, people who sell their own out for a good time, someone had to break it by speaking the truth. And actually healing. And actually stopping that behavior. In other words, stop selling out one's own. Stop abandoning one's own children. Stop selling one's own children out for 50 cents. Stop competing with one's own daughter or son. Stop competing and stealing from siblings. Stop trying to sabotage. Stop hoeing. Stop being a dark witch. If that was in the blood. Someone had to be the light and not based on this fucked up ass 3D programming. But for real. Not the outfit and the slogan to put on InstaFace and Facebook. It takes kahunas. Collective, if you're the one getting this dharma, you a bad motherfucker. That energy that's coming out as I'm speaking, that's because your ancestors or your higher self or whatever you are with, you a bad motherfucker. Because you took the call that nobody wanted to take. You took the call that everybody wanted to fake. They wanted you to do the work while reaping the benefit of it by sitting back and watching you, but not doing the work and then copycatting as if they awakened and ascended. I don't think so. The ancestors were not impressed by any of it. They're disgusted at it. It's a disgrace. Somebody's this. Damn. That's your dharma. All that light. Somebody's breaking cycles. Your dharma is you broke some kind of ancestral curse. For real. So that means for you and yours and what you do, this is the liberation. But the family members that was in the fucked up shit, it's the curse. They're stuck. They're going to be stuck for trying to fuck with the one that came here. For trying to sabotage that. From trying to steal from that, for trying to pretend to be that, for real, for real, for real. Okay. Final messages, my team. Thinking all you gotta do is copy and paste and Google some shit. Watch Divine Feminine and get the same setup and do what she do. It ain't like that. Somebody's over the wound. Wow. The wound is the place where the light enters you. It's in reverse. So, yeah, the heartache. Can you get just a little tensy, tiny bit grateful? Yeah. Look at you. You're like a wounded disco ball. Somebody is, oh, yeah. Somebody's dharma is that they're over the wounds. They're healing from the wounds that these people caused and created. They're healed. Ancestral stuff. It says you are not required to set yourself on fire to keep other people warm. It wanted to be in reverse, and I feel like that message is because the universe is saying some of you finally realize that people try to make you feel obligated. And for a long time, you felt obligated to set yourself on fire to try to help somebody. But now you're no longer in that energy. You're no longer, you got it. You understand, like, I'm not here to sacrifice myself for no dizzy lunatics. I am not here to sacrifice myself for karmics who don't want to wake the fuck up and heal. I am not here to sacrifice myself from some narc, abusive, tyrant motherfuckers posed as loving human beings. I am not here to be somebody's scapegoat and doormat and allow people to run over me and do what the fuck they want to do to me or mine and not say nothing. I'm going to fuck off on everybody, and if I have to, I'm a hammer on them, goddammit. I am not here to take shit from low vibrational motherfuckers, and I don't care who they are. If they want to get well, then they need to go the path like every fucking body else. I am not here to let people fucking mooch off of my ascension that they didn't want to do themselves but want to parade around like they have and steal shit they gonna pay exponentially. I am not here for that shit. Collective, if you're getting the Dharma, that's you. You're not here for that. And people going, if they didn't know, they fencing too. You're not here to be the scapegoat. You're not here so people can put their energetic garbage onto you. You're not here so people can project their lunatic-y energy onto you. You're here to change some shit. Somebody finally had the kahunas to do it. But it cost. Because in the process, people were fighting, stealing, lying, doing shit. We saw them reading. But y'all got the victory. You're protected. You're the phoenix rising. Start going towards what y'all want to do now. What lights you up? What makes you happy here? Okay? Start getting more in that energy. I'm setting intentions every day for myself, y'all. Okay? To get more in that energy of what lights me up. You know, you get used to having to do energetic kung fu and jiu-jitsu. You get used to it. But then, you know, getting back into the energy of, okay, what lights you up? What makes you happy? What puts a smile on your face? Okay? Very beautiful. You guys are free. Your Dharma is you are free from ancestral patterns and rewriting your future accordingly. A rising pillar of light. Your vibration is rising. Some of you guys are oracles. Okay? And you are protected and calling your energy back. It takes time to learn how to trust. All I can tell you all is this is why I like to embrace the hermit mode. What's funny is when people try to put the isolation spells on divine beings that actually like isolation, it's like that was dumb. I laugh at this almost every day. Because what happens is then they become enlightened and strong as fuck. And then their discernment gets sharper and sharper and sharper and sharper and sharper. It's like, well, you just helped me whoop your ass. That's essentially kind of what you did. You just helped me kind of be able to see your devilish ways and help me to be able to smell it. And you helped me to be able to whoop your ass. So now, as we continue to heal, you guys, I can promise you that the trusting part gets easier. You'll start trusting yourself and your energy and what you feel, okay? As you heal, though, because we have to do the detoxing and the healing and the aligning. And it takes time. And just be patient with yourself. There's no cookie-cutter template on it. But I can promise that it does get a little easier. And it's nothing wrong with kind of being a lone wolf to a degree until you're in such a vibrational place to where you know that you're now manifesting the higher side of it. Because for a while, we still manifest the lures as we're trying to sometimes get through the muck. And it's okay. You don't got to have a big old kapow about it and a speech, but just do yourself a loving solid and go, okay, not yet. I'm still healing. Okay, something is off. I'm not going to talk about it. I'm just going to know what I need to do. And ask your guides to help you. Ask your guides to give you revelation, even if it's in your sleep. These are things that I've had to learn how to just roll with it. And if something ain't right, I'm not afraid now. If something feels off, even if I'm not sure, I'm not afraid to put up a boundary and pull back, because that's going to give me the space that I need to talk to my guides, to put an intention out. So I'm not getting ready to jump into shit. I ain't gonna go to have snacks. You know, it's like I'm very, even when I deal with people now, it's like I go, but you can rest assured my energy, I'll be doing something with my energy and I'm watching. And then I have a cutoff, okay? I don't judge them. I don't get into it, but it's like, okay, their energy is a little murky. Okay, I'm just gonna pull back. No big deal. No big deal. Some of us, the lesson is about learning how to be to yourself and not alone. Because there are people who got folks surrounding them, but guess what? They're lonely. You can find in being to yourself, but be more not alone than the people who got five motherfuckers constantly surrounding them. So it takes us, though, being willing to go there so we can discover it. We have to discover it. Otherwise, it's theory, right? It's theory. You find your purpose. You find your interest. There's so much beautiful things that happens when you allow yourself to just be in your own energy for a while and not always trying to find somebody to hook up with they convoluted shit. You know what I'm saying? It's like, look, let me just be in my energy. Some of us need to learn how to just be in our own energy. We're so used to needing to be in somebody else's energy. And this is why we end up fucking up our lives, because we became codependent on needing to be in other people's energy all the time. So we are easily brought and sold. Until we learn, like, shit, ain't nothing more valuable than some good old peace. Shit, some legit. Shit. Whoa. Then people lose their power and control over you, because you ain't willing to jump through hoops just to sit down with them watching their movies and type of shit. You heard? All right. Anyway, let me get going. I'm way behind and I knew this would happen. So I hope this serves. I will try, but the next couple of days may be a little bit bloom on a good foot. So I can't guarantee it, but I'm going to try the next couple of days to get this in amongst the other mini readings up onto the YouTube platform. Okay. All right. Yeah, y'all. Ta-ta. Somebody's Dharma's Phoenix rising, motherfuckers. Show them how it's done, y'all. Show them how it's done. Love and light, y'all.